Yeah, that is something that I've also been thinking about, and there has been a growing chorus of insiders in the industry suggesting that UX is being misused by companies, and that, you know, as designers or whatever you want to call us, information architects, we're setting traps for our users and leading them into systems that might have interesting short-term incentives, but ultimately the long-term outcome for the user is poor. Are we misusing our gifts?
Yes. So I think it's a very hard problem. Back in the late 90s and early 2000s, when the internet was still a sort of an add-on to business, we were given a lot of freedom to just do cool stuff, and we could design things for users because the stakeholders, the executives, like, didn't really pay that much attention. And it's funny because I remember within our community, everyone would always be talking about, we need to get a seat at the table. We need to get the attention at the C level. And I always felt like, be careful what you ask for. Well, we've got the seat at the table now, and UX has been, fully integrated into the enterprise. But what that has done is that now, UX is just business. It's not, I want to make the world a better place by doing UX. It's, I'm part of this business enterprise that has a profit motive, and it's extremely hard to do true user-centered work with it when the broader context is what we might call late-stage capitalism, right? And so it's not so simple as saying, well, I'm just going to change things at my organization. I mean, you're fighting your culture. You're fighting the way that human civilization is working right now. And so we can all do our bit to try to make things a little better, but I do think that the bigger, I go back to Henry David Thoreau, I think was the one who talked about the notion of striking at the root, right? And it's like, for 1,000 people hacking at the branches, one strikes at the root. The idea, and it was Larry Lessig who popularized this in our community, after working with Creative Commons and sort of fighting for better things in copyright, he finally realized copyright, the problems with copyright are just one of 1,000 symptoms of a corrupt Congress in the United States. Unless we fix Congress, unless we fix corruption at the highest levels of government, we'll never fix any of these 1,000 specific things. And so he dedicated the next 10 years of his life to trying to change Congress. He was not very successful, but he did give it a good try.